Heading for a showdown on Capitol Hill, U.S. President Barack Obama insists he will go it alone on immigration reform. Republicans are warning they'll fight him tooth and nail. A high-stakes game of dare or part of a bigger battle to come. This is Inside Story. Hello and welcome to the program. I'm Mike Hanna. Whether it comes down to politics or pride or a bit of both, US President Barack Obama is facing a bumpy road ahead as he charts his final 2 years in office. Obama's Democrat Party was punished in midterm elections this month, with Republicans winning control of the Senate and adding to their majority in the House of Representatives. And battle lines are being drawn. The immediate fight Obama has on his hands is over proposed changes to the immigration system, offering protection for as many as 5 million immigrants living illegally in the U.S. from deportation. Republicans say any such action is beyond his authority. For a bill to become law in the U.S., it needs to be passed with a majority in both houses of Congress. If that happens, the president can then sign the bill into law or he can veto it. If it's vetoed, the House has an option to override the veto, but it needs a two-thirds majority. President Obama also has a range of what are called executive options available to him to push bills through, and he says he plans on using them by the end of the year to save his immigration plans. Kimberly Halkett has more.
8 years ago, Jose Luis Picil crossed into the United States illegally from Mexico. He lived quietly in the northeastern state of Connecticut with his wife and had two U.S.-born children. But now he faces deportation and separation from his family. So he's protesting the government agency actively working to send him back to Mexico.
We're thinking that any time they're going to send you back to your country. We come here looking for a better life, not because we expect them to toss us out like animals.
Picil argues federal law grants him and other illegal immigrants the right to remain in the United States if they have no serious criminal record. So Picil and five other illegal immigrants are suing the U.S. government agency, forcing them out. They hope to buy time while they wait on a promise by the White House to issue executive orders that could stop the deportations of millions of illegal immigrants.
We're deporting people that shouldn't be deported. We're not deporting folks that are dangerous and need to be deported.
So the White House is expected to soon announce new guidelines, providing as many as 5 million illegal immigrants with permits to stay in the United States. It may also allow immigrant parents with children born in the U.S. to receive work permits. But conservative lawmakers on Capitol Hill are promising to block the immigration reforms.
We're going to fight the president tooth and nail if he continues down this path. This is the wrong way to govern.
But immigrant rights activists argue legal precedents support President Obama taking unilateral action. Already, roughly 2 million illegal immigrants have been deported. Activists say President Obama's immigration reform is needed now before more families are torn apart.
He could have done that yesterday, he could have done that a year ago, and there's really no excuse why we should be dealing with the injury, the harm, the hurt, and the pain of over 2 million people that have been taken from our families and from our communities.
So Picil and other activists conducted a mock trial in front of the U.S. agency in charge of deportations. They hope to build public support for Picil's effort.
In my mind, there is always the idea to be with my children, to take them to school, to share my life with them. But these ideas are just dreams that are erased with everything that is happening to me.
Dreams, he says, that could become a reality if President Obama follows through on his promised immigration reforms. Kimberly Halkett, Al Jazeera, Washington.
Well, helping us navigate our way through this political minefield are our three guests for this Inside Story. In Washington, D.C., Simon Rosenberg, president and founder of the New Democrat Network, a leading think tank based in Washington, D.C. In New York, Cheri Jacobus, political consultation and Republican strategist. And also in Washington, D.C., we have Solon Simmons, associate professor at the School for Conflict Analysis and Resolution at George Mason University. Welcome to you all. Let's begin with Cheri Jacobus. Now, it would appear that Republican opposition is not so much on the nature of the legislation, but on the way that President Obama intends to pass it. Would that be correct?
First and foremost, that's the big hurdle, and that's where Republicans are united. You'll find Republicans have disagreement about some of the substance, and there's plenty of time for negotiation, plenty of room for those margins. But when you have the president coming through with this sweeping executive action, that is where there is a real problem. I think he could even have a problem with some Democrats. This last election, where it was a wave election for Republicans, definitely has Republicans with the wind at their backs. And so I think that President Obama may have overegged his pudding a little bit on this one. I don't think that he's going to have the sweeping support across the country that he may think he has.
Well, Simon Rosenberg, President Obama says that he's simply been waiting too long for the House of Representatives to act. Is this a valid motivation for passing executive orders at this time, do you believe?
I do, and I think that the president will win the debate if he can clearly get the American people on his side on whether this is good for the American economy, whether this is good for public safety, and whether this will make the immigration and border enforcement systems better. I think it will in all cases, and I think that's really going to be far more the battleground in the American public than whether it's legal or not. It's clearly legal, and there's clearly ample precedent for this. I think the Republicans are simply wrong about this, and if they don't like the law, I mean, if they think the law doesn't give the president the authority to do this, then they can change the law. They're in charge of Congress. I mean, they have a clear and simple vehicle next year to revoke the president's actions through the legislative process.
Solon, Simmons, there have been meetings shortly after the midterm elections in which the Republicans did so well. President Obama sat down with House leaders. There was talk of bipartisanship, of all working together during these next few weeks before Congress stops. Part of the Republican opposition appears to be the fact that this isn't a form of betrayal of any bipartisan agenda. Would you see it as such?
Well, I think that you have to ask yourself the question, why is this happening now? And the immigration debate, although it's a crucial one, it affects millions of individuals and families, and it's destructive of so many possibilities of realizing a good life for so many people. But at the same time, as a political issue, it's never all that prominent. If you look historically as the most important problem, it tends not to be at the top of the list like the economy almost always is, and healthcare now is. And even as you got closer to the election, it started to dwindle. So there's a reason where you have to ask yourself, why is this happening now? And as I understand it, it's the Republican Party needs this issue in some sense to unify its two different wings. You've got a kind of a populist wing, a libertarian populist wing focused on issues of economic inequality and shared prosperity, and then the traditional Republican. And so if you have a shared enemy, a common enemy in the president, which they obviously already do, but this helps them to justify why they can be more aggressive, then I think you can have a unity against that common enemy, and it builds on certain tensions already that are implicit around race and ethnicity in the country. And in a way, as I see it, what I think happens is you shift the tension from that question of shared prosperity and how do we get there, which no one really seems to have a good answer to on the Democratic or Republican side, and you focus it more on your concerns about globalization, about the other, and about what's happening to your community. So I think the Republican Party needs this fight. I think it's good for them. I don't think the president wanted to have it now, and I don't think he wants to be cast as a kind of an executive who's taking away power from the people rather than arguing and defending his position in public.
Well, Cheri Jacobus, what do you think of that point that the Republicans need this for their own unity?
Well, I don't know if they need it or not. I think it's something that needs to be dealt with. And of course, they're split on some of the tactics on this. When you're talking about a potential, by tying it to appropriations and basically shutting down the government, there's some concern that Republicans would pay a huge political price for this in 2016, but we really didn't pay a price in this last election. And I would also like to say that this last election, this wave election for Republicans, was in large part not to work with President Obama. It was to stop President Obama, and in part from these types of executive orders. In terms of a precedent with Reagan and some of the others, there was so-called amnesty. It was very in small proportions, very targeted, and it was mostly done really for purposes of political asylum. So it was a different case. So I don't think you can make these sweeping generalizations. Whether or not this would stand up in court, you know, Senator Ted Cruz says that that this is illegal. I think it's worth the test there. And if it's found to be legal that the president is doing it, I think Republicans can win it on the politics. I just want to say one really important thing, and I've been saying this for years. It is absolutely ridiculous and untrue for anybody, be they Republicans or Democrats, to tie securing our border to an overall immigration or illegal immigration package. That is something that should be done immediately. There's no excuse for it not to be. And now that we also have health concerns with infectious diseases coming over the border, as well as homeland security issues, there's absolutely no excuse. So whoever is in charge, they win points with the American people by just securing our border, whether there's an R after their name or a D.
Well, Simon Rosenberg, I mean, as you heard, there's potential for major debate on the actual aspects of the legislation itself. Yet this is going to be pushed aside in terms of what will be a straight political fight between Congress and the president.
Well, but there's nothing stopping the Republicans from pursuing legislative, either revoking what the president's done through legislative means or passing their own immigration bills to override what the president's about to do. Let's be clear about this, right? The original bill to deal with this enormous undocumented population that we have in the United States was introduced 9 years ago. The Republicans have blocked it four different times, including this in this last Congress in 2014. The president met with John Boehner earlier this year and said, if you don't finally get around to passing this immigration reform bill, which is broadly supported in the American public, broadly supported in the American business community, religious community, the labor community, then I'm going to take unilateral action. He was very clear with the public. He said, I'm going to do this if the Republicans don't act. The Republicans didn't act, I would argue, in a very, showing an extreme lack of courage in tackling a major national problem. And so the president's doing what he said he was going to do. I mean, he's been very clear about this. And that's why we're going to do it. I think at the end of the day, the president will win this debate if the country believes that this has been good for the economy, good for our public safety, good for border security, which it clearly will be. And I can get into that if you want to talk more about it. And if we can make that case, I think he's going to win this debate with the public.
Cheri, Jacobus, let's be really clear here. Now, if this legislation was introduced a few weeks later when Congress had reconvened in January with the majority in the House and, of course, the new majority in the Senate, would there have been a debate and would there have been less targeting President Obama himself?
I think that the president is going to have a problem with the American people no matter what, and they are represented in Congress, and they just spoke loud and clear in this last election. And in terms of him making the case to the American people that that amnesty for illegals is good for the economy, good for border security, he has not been able to make that case so far. And I would also note that Republicans did better in this last election less than 2 weeks ago with Hispanics than expected. That could continue. When you start looking at this issue closely, when people start looking at the various details and the nuances, they are going to be thinking it through a little bit more carefully. They're not going to be as susceptible to having an emotional reaction based on claims of racism or all Republicans are this or all that. I think that this is something that there can be an honest and open discussion. I think it can be fought in the courts. And I do think Republicans can and should come up with legislation to undo it should the president. I think they should do all of the above, frankly, whether or not, they have the 60 votes in the Senate, to get this done, is that could be another story. But I think it's a good debate to have. I think Americans deserve the debate and deserve to hear the nuances rather than just the sound bites and the hyperbole and the various political charges that you see just in a headline.
Solon Simmons, to what extent is this legislation, which will impact on the lives of millions of people, actually being diverted, being in effect set aside by an extremely bad relationship, very early bad relationship between the House, maybe the Senate, and the President? To what extent are these personal animosities actually impinging on passing legislation that should be passed?
It's a great question. And you say they're personal animosities, and they are, but I think it's really what I would call, as a conflict resolution, professor of conflict resolution, a conflict dynamic. where arguments become very simplified. They do become personal. They become very general, so they're about everything, not the specific issue, the operational details of the specific problem. And I think also we become captured or prisoners of the narrative, of the conflict narrative. And as I see it, there's a story of insecurity on one side that we need to protect our borders and be safe, and on the other side, there's intolerance and racism. And I think neither of those arguments, if you think those broad stories, allow for creativity in this particular moment, because I think it is a very pressing problem around immigration. But it's also a question of why is it that people feel so insecure? And there's, for me, this election recently was about Ebola, ISIS, or the caliphate, and to some extent about the other and about the invasion of the other more generally. But those are not forward-looking ideas. Those are not images of America which will allow it to be a leader in the new world order that's coming in its relations with Russia and China and others. So I think that it's a very difficult moment because you can win elections in this way, but it's not clear how you solve problems. And I think that's going to be the crucial issue. And one of the great problems is a sense of economic insecurity. Those of us who have positions which allow us to prosper are doing just fine. But so many of Americans, especially in the heartland, especially in all those that increasingly large rural red zone, don't have great prospects. And dealing with this problem, I don't know, will address the major forces behind that.
Well, Cheri Jacobus, what are the Republican options here? There has been talk, as you mentioned a short while ago, of actually refusing to pass the funding bill, for example, which needs to be passed by December the 11th or renewed by December the 11th. And yet there does appear to be a division among Republicans in terms of what to do, in terms of the threat of having a partial government shutdown again, as happened in 2013. What is the debate among Republicans at the moment in terms of how they are going to deal with this?
Well, you know, there are some hard conservatives that do want that, you know, and do this with the continuing resolution and do the shorter term and then go revisit this again in March and try and hope to get President Obama to cave, basically, on some of these points. This early on, you know, there's 2 more years before an election, they could. You know, this type of a fight might actually energize the Republicans and show that they're serious. I think they should also basically sue the president over this and test this in the courts. And again, even if it's found to be technically legal, they should be able to win the argument politically. This is something that the American people care about. We do care about securing the border. I think that right now, people around the country don't necessarily trust Washington to address this without the politics. And again, as I mentioned before, they could secure our border immediately and separate that out from everything else. And I think that you would find a lot of people who right now don't want to hear anything about amnesty. They just want this taken care of. They don't trust Washington. If the president and Congress, they insisted on securing the border first, I think you might actually find a lot of people that previously were not open to the idea of any type of amnesty to be able to look at it now. But they want the problem separated. American people are pretty smart. They know when they're being hoodwinked. And when you try and say that we can't secure our border unless we do all of these other things, we know that that's not correct. We know we're being hoodwinked. So I think that Washington, Republicans and Democrats could get the trust of the American people if first and foremost they secure the border. It can be done immediately. We're capable of doing it. For some reason, it's not being done.
Well, Simon Rosenberg, this is a debate once again that does deserve airing, but at this particular stage, it may not get that airing because of the opposition between the House, between the Republicans and the Democrat president. The same question I put to Cheri Jacobus is, could sure. President Obama have not waited a few weeks' time, shown a gesture of bipartisan governance to the Republicans who would soon be a majority in both House and Senate? Was that not a possibility? Did he have to enact this legislation now by executive order?
Again, he told the Republicans earlier this year that if they didn't pass a bill that passed with 68 votes in the Senate with broad bipartisan support, that he was going to go ahead and do this. And I think that where my colleague is completely wrong is on the notion that this won't actually make our border safer. Let's be very clear about this, right, is that by doing the executive action, we're going to allow 4 to 5 million people to contribute more to the American economy. We will be able to enhance our public safety by making sure that we're deporting criminals and murderers and rapists over regular everyday moms. It's going to make our public safety better. It's going to allow us to move additional resources to the border to make sure that people aren't coming in. And let's be clear about something the Republicans are saying all the time that's just false and wrong, which is that under Bill Clinton, we had about 600,000 undocumented immigrants come into the United States every year. Under George Bush, it was 400,000. Under Barack Obama, it's been zero. The net flow of undocumented immigrants into the United States over 6 years now has been zero. There's been no increase. We have, the border is under control, right? We do have, crime is down across the entire U.S. side of the border. The two safest large cities in America today are El Paso and San Diego, the two biggest cities on the U.S. border. This whole argument about border security that the Republicans are making is just hogwash. And this president has done more to secure the border than any president in American history. Over and out, period. It's an indisputable fact. And so the point is that he has done a good job in making the system far better than it was. The changes we're going to make are going to make the system even better. We're going to enhance American security, create more economic opportunity. That's what the president's going to do. And he's going to do it because he promised the American people and the Republicans he was going to do it if they didn't act. And that's why we're going to see this happen in the next couple of weeks.
Well, Solon, Simmons, we keep on getting into the merits.
Sounds nice, but that's not going to be happening. And we don't know how many undocumented people have come in the country. They've been flooding over the border. They've been flooding the border.
It's just false and wrong. It's false and wrong.
They don't feel that.
You have to stop saying something that's not true.
And they don't.
Well, let's just go to Solon Simmons here, because we're arguing about the merits of legislation. I'll give you a moment now, Cheri. But we're arguing about the merits of something, and yet what is happening as well is the very essence of governance itself is being threatened in a way. We're not just looking at immigration legislation. Obama's going to need a new attorney general. There are some 60 State Department posts still need to be filled that have not been filled because of obstruction by Republicans. Is this just another example that the next 2 years are going to get worse in terms of actual governance, in the terms of the way the system works?
I think it's difficult to imagine that it will not become more difficult to govern. I think there's a reason why this fight is happening. I don't know that it, I mean, securing the border aside, I think that there's a sense that this is a good fight to have in the Republican side. If you look at the data from the exit polls, it's Republican voters who thought that the immigration issue was the most important issue. It wasn't on the Democratic side. And I think it's important to know, too, because, I think that my colleagues are caught up in this conflict dynamic just as I am, but it's a very negative tone that it's very difficult to avoid. What we know about negative campaigning, and as there's more money in the system, that becomes more common, is that it's very boring. The public is kind of tuning out. As much as this was a real debate in this election, the American people did decide. At the same time, it was the worst turnout in 72 years. There's something about the current environment which just has people disgusted, and they're not really tuning in. So I suspect that this is going to get more heated. I suspect that it's going to get more simplified and mean-spirited. And I think it's going to be difficult for all of us who are serious about producing real change to do this in an interesting way, which is at the same time principled. So I do think it's going to, you ought to pay attention. It's going to get more heated.
Cheri Jacobus, that word mean-spirited, is that what we've got to look forward to for 2 years?
The American people should get a little bit worried if everybody in Washington gets along too well. I mean, this is what we do in a democracy. So it's always going to be spirited, sometimes mean, sometimes not so mean. But as long as it's an honest, open fight, and it will be a fight, but it's an important fight to have, I think we're okay. But again, I think that the Republicans should probably try all of the above. Try this in the courts, win it on the politics. Separate out the things that are important. And again, I can't say this enough. If you secure the borders now and let the American people know they're serious about it, then you're going to find people a lot more open to some of the other things being discussed. But right now, I just don't think that voters really trust Washington. So I think that this is a good fight to have. And I think that since it's going to be high profile, people are going to be paying attention. And the politicians in Washington on both sides might not be able to get away with some of the hyperbole and claims without backing it up. They're going to be closely watched, and that's a good thing.
At that particular stage, my thanks to our guests, Simon Rosenberg, Cheri Jacobus, and Solon Simmons. And we're always interested to hear what you have to say on this and other issues. You can leave your comments at facebook.com/AJ Inside Story. We're also on Twitter. Our handle is @AJInsideStory. I'm Mike Hanna. Thanks for watching, and goodbye for now.